why I chose the Hong Kong Jockey Club. I chose it because it's a very famous Hong Kong icon and it has a very big charity. It's also a very famous tourist attraction. A brief history of Hong Kong. It's a city in China with 7 million residents. Before 1997, it was a British colony, and British was the one that brought horse racing to Hong Kong. About the Hong Kong Jockey Club. The Hong Kong Jockey Club has a very good charity. They earn about $30 billion a year. They do horse racing, hence the name Hong Kong Jockey Club. They do football betting and lottery betting. They also have a 16 or over age limit, and they also give to their community a lot. It was established in 1884. They earned 38.9 billion US dollars in COVID. They have 25,000 employees, and they're being the largest employee in Hong Kong. They have 800 races every year. They usually do two times a week of horse races. No horse races in July and August due to the extreme heat making the horses overheat. There's 1,200 current racing horses, and the horses are usually from Australia, New Zealand, and England. They're just very many. About the Hong Kong Jockey Club's charity work. The Hong Kong Jockey Club has a charity company called the Hong Kong Jockey Club's Charity Trust. In their response to COVID, they gave the elderly and underprivileged families food, water, and hand sanitizer face masks. They helped fund a bunch of schools and research labs. They donate an average of 5 billion US dollars every year to 250 charity programs. This is a charity company for the underprivileged families. This is a nursing school for if you want to learn how to nurse elderly. This is a rehabilitation center, and this is their visa education program. And that's it.
Can you tell us a little bit about your model?
My model is a stadium and a horse race track. This is a park, and there's two tracks, one grass and one dirt. I try to make people. It's not very good.
Did you, so the music that was playing as we were listening to the
video? No, it was just added.
Is that the one that you played? What is that?
No, it was just added in the video. It's not like the real one. And also it has like different instruments.
Oh, okay.
So it's not.
Got it. Here. So what are we getting ready to listen to? So Minna, as hard as Miss Cardella tried to bring a keyboard up here and have her play in person, she chose to do it and send us a video. So tell us what we're getting ready to listen to.
It's William Tell Overture, but it's not the real one. It's kind of just the easy one because it's very big.
I like easy. All right.